Hello friends, this is Supriya. Welcome back to my channel Biology Reader. Today in this video we will discuss the microbial spoilage of food. So friends, let's get started. Microbial food spoilage is defined as the contamination of food by the growth and activity of the microorganisms. However, food spoilage can also occur through chemical degradation and physical injury. Food spoilage by the microorganisms depends upon the pH, moisture and nutrient content of the food. Microbial spoilage of food is evidenced by the change in appearance, change in texture, change in color, and change in taste and odor. And such changes make the food unfit for human consumption. Let us discuss some key points before proceeding to the theory of microbial food spoilage. Food spoilage can be resulted through insect damage, physical injury, chemical changes, and microbial attack. Microbial food spoilage is caused due to the growth and activity of the microorganisms. The enzymatic activity by the microorganisms is responsible for the food degradation, like hydrolysis of proteins by the proteolytic enzymes, rancidity by the lipolytic microbes, etc. Food serves as a growth medium for microorganisms as it contains proteins, carbohydrates, and lipids that are utilized by the microorganisms. Microbial food spoilage can be controlled by the techniques like refrigeration, lyophilization, and by adding preservatives. Microbial spoilage depends upon the factors like food matrix, it means the physical and chemical properties of food, then the type of microorganisms, and the food storage conditions. Now we will study the causes of microbial food spoilage. Storage conditions like temperature and oxygen are the external factors influencing food spoilage. Saccharophilic temperature, it means minus 17 degrees Celsius, can prevent growth of microorganisms and considered safe. But mesophilic temperature between 20 to 40 degrees Celsius is most favorable for the microbial growth. Therefore, warm conditions is optimal for the growth of mesophilic and thermophilic microorganisms like Listeria, Pseudomonas, Staphylococcus, and Escherichia species. Then oxygen is another factor influencing microbial food spoilage. Aerobic storage conditions favor the growth of aerobic bacteria and molds on the food surfaces, whereas anaerobic storage conditions favor the growth of anaerobic bacteria like Clostridium species. Then chemical properties of food like food composition, pH and moisture content are the internal factors influencing microbial spoilage. Starting with the food chemical composition, proteolytic microbes degrade protein-rich foods through protease enzymatic activity and produce amino acids, amines, ammonia, etc. Carbohydrate fermenting microbes like some yeast, mold and bacteria break down carbohydrate rich foods and produce acid, alcohol and gas. Lipolytic microorganisms degrade lipid or fat rich foods to produce fatty acids and glycerol, and they include some molds and gram negative bacteria. Then food pH also influences the growth of specific microorganisms. pH below 4.5 favors the growth of yeast and mold, and high pH favors the bacterial growth. Then the moisture within the food also favors microbial growth. 13% of free water favors microbial growth, but high sugar and salt concentration can prevent the growth of microorganisms. At last, we will discuss the common microorganisms that are involved in the food spoilage and how they degrade the food material. Yeast are the unicellular fungi that cause food fermentation. They require low pH and moisture to cause food spoilage. True yeast converts sugar into alcohol and carbon dioxide, whereas false yeast grow on the food surface as a dry film. Then molds are another type of fungi that are multicellular. They produce a visible mass on the food surface called mycelium. They require oxygen, slightly acidic pH, moisture, and temperature between 20 to 40 degrees Celsius to cause food spoilage. Then bacteria are the prokaryotic microbes that cause food spoilage under low moisture, warm environment, neutral acidic conditions. Here the examples are also given that are involved in food degradation. Now let us summarize the steps that how the microbial growth leads to the food decomposition. First, microbes attack the food at favorable conditions. Then they degrade the food material by utilizing the nutrients available in the food. After that, enzymatic reactions occur between the microbial enzymes and the food chemical components, and this results into some chemical changes. Finally, we can observe the changes in the food material in the form of changes in color, appearance, texture, etc. So friends, this is all for today. I hope you find this lesson useful. To know this topic more in detail, you can visit our official website, that is biologyreader.com. Link is provided in the description box. So friends, do like, comment, share and subscribe my channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos.